Hello students, how are you doing? I hope you are doing great. Today we are going to study your second unit B section from English Channel book from 8th class. Students, let us see the name of the chapter, that is Back from the Brink. Have you visited a wildlife sanctuary or a thick forest area? And if you visited, how did you feel? Tell me what attracted you the most at that place. You can write in description box. You may answer differently. Some would say animals, some would say greenery, some would say birds. Okay, children. Today we are going to read in this chapter about two documentary filmmakers, Shilpi Sharma and Rita Banerjee, who were on a mission in the dense forest of Northeast India. Let us discuss title of the chapter, that is Back from the Brink. Brink means edge, means kinara, means to come back from an edge. मीन्स किनारे पर जाकर वापिस आना, मीन्स किसी एक्सट्रीम उसमें पहुंच जाना, डिस्टिंक्शन में पहुंच जाना. जस्ट लाइक नाउ व्हाट इज एन एज, एज हियर इज डिस्टिंक्शन ऑफ वाइल्ड एनिमल्स, कि वाइल्ड एनिमल्स फिनिश होते जा रहे थे, खत्म होते जा रहे थे. सो हियर व्हेन द वाइल्ड एनिमल्स वर गोइंग टू फिनिश, द हंटर्स डिड सच अमेजिंग वर्क that they regain the wild animal again. So let us see how did they do. Let us read the chapter and find out. Let us start reading chapter. Deep in a forest in the northeast, Sai set down his backpack of cane and bamboo. Cane means the hollow jointed stem of a tall grass, especially bamboo or sugar cane, and bamboo at the base of the tree. Barefoot, he clasped the trunk. Clasped means held, coach. Barefoot means nange paon. The trunk means jo tana hota hai, that is called middle body of the tree, that is called trunk. With his arms and legs and climbed up to about the 9 meters high. Swiftly means quickly. He slid across a thick horizontal branch. Slid across means fisalna. Ek horizontal branch thi, uske saath fisla wo, and extracted a dead red-bellied squirrel. Extracted means took out. Red-bellied squirrel means jiska stomach red hai. Stomach ki taraf red color ki hai squirrel. From the handmade trap. Now what is a trap? Trap is a device to catch and retain animals. He had said much earlier. In the deep forest of Northeast, Sai set down his back that was made of canes at the base of the tree. He was barefooted. He coached his arm and legs, the trunk of the tree, and climbed about 9 meters high. Then he quickly slid across a horizontal branch. Horizontal, you can say, जो vertical नहीं होती, सीधी नहीं होती, horizontal जो tree होते हैं उनके side से जो branch निकली होती है. Maybe is there any tree branch not there here? It's okay. And took out a dead red bellied squirrel from the handmade trap that he set there much earlier. Students, I'm going to tell you about Tai. A Tai Jaro Maga were young Nishi tribals who were helping the filmmakers, that is Rita Banerjee and who is the other? I told you in the beginning, Shilpi Sharma, to make a documentary film. Means they were helping. They were young Nishi tribals, means young bachche the. You can see in the picture, these are the tribals. Let us read the next para. To split down the tree and was on the ground in less than 30 seconds, Magar took the squirrel, turned it over, and then placed it in his backpack. Backpack, you understand, the bag which you hang at your back. As we continued along the path means way, slipping and slithering across leaf litter. मीन्स जो लीफ का गार्बेज फैला हुआ था, लिटर मीन्स गार्बेज जो फैला हुआ था, उस पर वो फिसलते हुए चल रहे थे, मतलब वो अच्छे से चल नहीं पा रहे थे. आर कंपेनियंस, कंपेनियंस मीन्स फ्रेंड्स, पॉइंटेड आउट, पॉइंटेड आउट मीन्स इंडिकेटेड, मीन्स इशारा किया. अदर ट्रैप्स ऑन द वे, कैमराज इन हैंड, वी यूजली क्रॉस्ड गशिंग स्ट्रीम्स. गशिंग मीन्स फुल ऑफ, जो पानी की भरी हुई थी उसके ऊपर जो ब्रिज था वहां से उन्होंने क्रॉस किया उसको. अनस्टेडली मीन्स नॉट स्टेबली, मतलब वो स्टेबल नहीं थे, वो बार बार में हिल रहे थे, शेकी हो रहे थे. बिकॉज द ब्रिज वॉज मेड ऑफ ए सिंगल ट्री ट्रंक, मतलब सिंगल ट्री ट्रंक से ब्रिज बना था. यू कैन इमेजिन. जे आर ओ मिमिक्ड, मिमिक्ड मीन्स कॉपीड, द साउंड ऑफ ए बार्किंग डियर फॉन इन डिस्ट्रेस. डिस्ट्रेस मीन्स अपसेट. बार्किंग डियर फॉन मीन्स डियर का बच्चा. Hopping to lure, lure means attract its mother. Dense forest crowded around us, making it impossible to see further than a few meters ahead. Our pace was much slower than we hoped. Pace means speed. क्यों थी उनकी speed कम? Because way was very shaky. वो जो और जंगल का रास्ता था और जो ब्रिज बना था वो एक सिंगल ट्रंक से बना था. लेट अस सी द एक्सप्लेनेशन. देन टाई स्लिड डाउन द ट्री एंड केम डाउन इन लेस देन 30 सेकंड. यू कैन सी हाउ क्विक दे वर. मगर टुक दैट स्क्विरल एंड टर्न इट ओवर एंड देन पुट इट इन हिज बैकपैक. दे वर गोइंग अहेड इन द जंगल, स्लीपिंग एंड स्लिदरिंग अक्रॉस द लीफ गार्बेज. द ऑथर्स कंपेनियंस indicated other traps. They were having cameras in their hands. They were shakily crossed gushing streams over the bridge. Gushing streams means full of water, which were making of made of single tree trunk. Then Jaro imitated the sound of a upset barking deer fawn to attract the mother deer. The forest were very dense, so thick that they couldn't see further than a few meters. Due to this, their speed of walking was very slow. Let's see the next para. We continued to film the three young men and walked until evening before settling down at a clearing. Our Nishi companions brewed black tea, brewed means prepared, and we sat around a small fire. As I gazed into the flames, I recalled how our sojourn, sojourn means trip, in the northeast began. Let us see explanation. They were making films on three young Nishi tribals, Tai, Zaro, and Maga. I told you these are the young Nishi tribals. The writer and her companions walked till evening before sunset. Then her Nishi friends prepared a black tea for them. As they were sitting around the small fire and sipping their tea, the writer recalled how their trip in northeast began. मतलब उनका जो ये trip है northeast में कैसे begin हुआ, writer ये remember कर रही है. Hunting is common in all the seven northeastern states of India. Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Nagaland, Tripura, Manipur, Meghalaya, and Mizoram. Tai, Maga, and Jaro are from one of the Nishi tribals who have been hunting in these forests for generations. The animals they hunt provide food and bones, furs, and feathers for decoration and ritual during their festivals. Here, It is told, sea hunting is common in all the seven northeastern states of India, that is sorry, I have left this para. Let us read this. In 2002, we filmed the very first rehabilitation of two Himalayan black bear cubs orphaned by hunting in the Paki National Park in Arunachal Pradesh. This is the national park in Arunachal Pradesh. Name is Paki National Park. But sadly, we knew that even with a successful relocation. Now, what is relocation? Move to a new place and establish one's home. Nothing stopped the bears from being hunted down again as adults. So, in 2002, they filmed on the restoration of two Himalayan black bear cubs who were orphaned by hunting. Means the bear cubs who were orphaned by hunting, they gave him a new place in the Paki National Park in Arunachal Pradesh. But it was very sad that after moving to new place and establish their new home, hunting bear didn't stop. Means जो बियर की हंटिंग थी वो रुकी नहीं. Let us read next para. Hunting is common in all the seven northeastern state of India, Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Nagaland, Tripura, Manipur, Meghalaya, and Mizoram. Tai, Maga, and Jaro are from one of the Nishi tribals who have been hunting in these forests for generations. The animals they hunt provide food and bones, furs and feathers for decoration and ritual during most festivals. Now here is told, what did they get from the birds or animals which they hunt? Let us see the explanation. Hunting is very common in the Assam, Nagaland, Manipur, Arunachal Pradesh, Meghalaya and Mizoram. Tai, Maga and Jaro, who were one of the Nishi tribals, they have been hunting in these forests for generations. And why they hunt animals? They hunt animals to get food, bones, furs and feathers for decorations and rituals during most of these festivals. Let us see the see this writer and her friend. Let us see the next para. Over the years, the tribal realized that the demand for the animal and birds they hunted was growing steadily. Steadily means continuously. Hornbills, barbets, these are the animals, birds. Civets, squirrels, and many more rare species were making their appearance as dead meat at village markets with price ranging from 500 rupees to 5,000 rupees. A barking deer was sold to rupees 6,000. But wild meat in the market could only mean one thing, that forest after forest was going silent. There was a strange and empty sky. Empty means vacant, Khali, where the wild birds used to fly. The next victim could very well be the forest itself. Let us see explanation. As the time passed by, these hunters realized that demand for the animals which were being hunted by them is growing continuously. The cost of the dead meat of hornbill, barbet, civets, squirrel and other rare species was rupees 500 to 5,000. The cost of barking deer was rupees 6,000. Means barking deer was more costly. Costlier, sorry. It means that they had to hunt more of these animals to fulfill the demand, and as a result, forests were becoming silent. Means wild animals were finishing, and animals finished, forests would be cut down for their livelihood. Means they would start cutting forest itself for their livelihood. लेट अस सी द नेक्स्ट पैरा. नाउ आर ऑल कंज्यूमिंग गोल. गोल मीन्स एम, छोटा पार्ट होता है एम का, मतलब उनका जो लक्ष्य था वाज टू डॉक्यूमेंट द एक्सटेंट ऑफ हंटिंग एंड टू डिटरमाइन वेदर देयर वाज ओनली होप फॉर द फ्यूचर ऑफ वाइल्ड लाइफ इन द नॉर्थ ईस्ट. इन द प्रोसेस वी स्पेंड टाइम विद सेवरल ट्राइब्स इंक्लूडिंग द अपाटनीज, चेक, सेंग एंड निशीज एंड अटेंडेड मैनी ऑफ देयर फेस्टिवल्स. We witnessed the traditional uses of animal parts, monkeys' fur, cats' claws, skin of bears and other animals, and the beaks of hornbills. On one occasion, while filming in a village, we came across a young boy, came across means they met, who had just returned with a monkey kill. He wanted to use the fur to make a new case for his dao. Dao means dagger. Dagger means knife. His reason was simple. He was attending a wedding and it was a matter of prestige. Prestige means respect, honor. It would be much better than the other boy's dagger case. Now the writer's goal was to document the extent of hunting and to see if there was any hope for future wildlife in the northeast. So the writer spent time with many other tribals like Apatani, Cheksang, and Nishis, and they attended their festivals. This writer and his friends, her friends, attended their festivals too. They saw. So how did they use the parts of different animals? How they use the parts of different animals, just like monkeys' fur, cats' claws, skin of bears and other animals, and the beaks of hornbills. The writer is telling us that the incidents related to this. She's going to tell us an incident related to this. One day they met a boy who came back after killing a monkey, and he wanted to use the fur of monkey to make a case for his sword, for his knife. Why he wanted to make a case for his sword? Because he was going to attend a marriage and it was a matter of prestige, means it was a matter of respect, it was a matter of show. He wanted to show that, he wanted to show his dagger case to his friends. He wants that his dagger case should look much beautiful than the other boys of his village. In Chijami village, Nagaland, the interviews we did with different generations of hunters revealed some interesting facts about the decline in wildlife here. The older hunters were intimate knowledge. Intimate means deep knowledge of the animals, their habitat. Habitat means जहाँ पे वो रहते हैं, means their home, their food, even their smell. They could identify means recognize the animals from the photographs very easily. The younger hunters had much less information on the animals, and the teenage boy had seen hardly any mammals. This was enough means sufficient to make them realize that hunting had reached crisis proportion. Crisis proportion means with very extreme damage. Here the author telling us that when they conducted interviews of different generations of hunters, and she came to know that some interesting facts of decreasing of wildlife, means why the wildlife was decreasing. The older hunters were having deep knowledge about wild animals, their habitat, their food. Even they could identify wild animals with their smell. Their photograph. But the younger hunter had very less knowledge about all these things. They didn't have any knowledge of these things. And teenagers had no knowledge at all, and this realized them their hunting has reached to a state of extreme damage because no animals were left there. That's why they were not able to recognize the animals. In January 2007, the tribal people of Rachi village had arrived at a consensus. A self-imposed ban on hunting for 3 years was the only way to reverse the situation. Earlier in Konama, Nagaland, the youth had taken it upon themselves a ban hunting as their forests were almost silent. Incredibly, they managed to sustain the ban for 10 years to revive means restore the wildlife population and set up infrastructure for ecotourism. Let us see the explanation. In 2007, the tribal people of Rachi did a general agreement among themselves, and they imposed a ban on hunting for 3 years on themselves. This was the only way to improve, means to save wildlife. The hunters of Konama, Nagaland also did the same, and it was unbelievable that they sustained this ban for 10 years to impose. For 3 years they banned for on themselves, but they sustained it for 10 years. The condition of wildlife improved. They started an operation for ecotourism. Let us see the last para. Many of the hunters we spoke to were willing means desire to be wildlife guides, you know, when they show tourist jungle. If they were given a chance to make a livelihood in Manas, Assam, there is already a successful example where ex-poachers means hunters, have turned into forest guides, putting their intimate means deep knowledge of the forest and its denizen means citizen of forest, to far better use. A powerful example of change. These are first steps, but positive ones, towards a more sustainable future. They have proved that protecting and preserving our forest and all creatures means animals, great and small, is not a spectator sport. Let us see the explanation. The author talked to many hunters who wanted to do work as guides for livelihood, means for their earning. It means the ex-hunters have already turned themselves into the forest guides. As they had a deep knowledge of the forest, of the wildlife, it was a powerful example of change. These were first but positive steps to maintain future where people would continue to have access to natural resources for a long time. We should better this is all, but there is a moral lesson in this chapter, means we should save our wildlife as well as our forest, otherwise the forest would become would finish and they become silent, means there would be no wildlife be left. That is all. Thank you for watching the video.